Hey everyone, it's Zoe here from OctoStudio. I was thinking it would be fun to make a cooking simulator or like a recipe maker where you have to like shake to add the salt in. So yeah, let me show you how to make a project like that.
So to get started with your project, you can open up the OctoStudio app and tap create new project. And then for your cooking simulator, you can either choose a backdrop first or a sprite first. I'm going to tap choose a backdrop, and you could either choose one of the backdrops we have here for your game, or you could also, if you wanted to, tap the camera, which I'm going to do, and I'm going to take a picture of this counter and have that be the background in my game. So now you can decide what you want the final recipe you're making in the game to be. I'm going to make a cake making game, but you could make it whatever recipe you want. It could be one of your favorite foods or a food from a show. So let's add a sprite. That can be the first ingredient, and the food and drink category is pretty helpful. So since in my game the player will be making a cake, I'm gonna have the first ingredient be salt, so I will add the salt. And I'm also going to tap this button to add another sprite and add a bowl. I think it's in the food category. Okay, yes, I wanna add a bowl of some kind to be mixing my ingredients in, so I will just make this a little larger. And okay, let's make it so that the first step in our game is that the player has to shake the phone to add an ingredient to the mix. So one way you can do that, and actually I'm going to tap here and tap on the salt shaker to add code for the salt shaker. And a way we can make this ingredient be shaken into the bowl is we could drag out this jump block and you can tap on it to test it out. You can see that it makes the sprite jump. And if we go to the when to start category and drag out a when I shake block and put it on top. Now, oh, you know what? I might have to change the sensitivity. So if you tap here, you can change how much the player needs to shake the phone for it to detect the shake. But now if I shake it, you can see that it makes the salt bounce. Now, another thing we could do is if we go to the motion category and drag out a turn block and put it on top, you'll see it actually looks like the salt is tilted and being tipped into the bowl, which I like that. We could also, if you go to the control category, you could drag out a repeat block. And if you put the jump inside the repeat block, it will make it repeat the jump 5 times. So it really looks like the salt is being added. Now you can also adjust this jump if you want. So you could adjust the speed by tapping this shoe. I'm gonna make it the fastest speed because I kind of like that. And you can also adjust how high the jump is by tapping this number. So if I put in 20, it's like a smaller jump. And if I attach this back on, now when I shake the phone, it tilts the salt and adds it. You know, another thing I could do is make it turn back the other direction after it does this. So I will attach another turn block and put it underneath. And if you tap here, you can change the direction of the turn if you want to. And then now if I shake the phone, it tilts the salt and then it turns back in the other direction. And also, if you tap the play button, the angle will reset to pointing upwards. Oh, and you know what? Let's also add a sound. So you can go to the sounds category, and if I drag out a play sound block and attach it on top, let's try that. So now when I shake the phone, it plays the sound and then does the shaking animation. One thing you could also do if you want it to play the sound and then immediately start playing the animation is tap here and choose and continue. And then as you'll see, that makes it so that it plays the sound, but then it immediately starts doing the next blocks you have under that. Okay, so that's good for our first ingredient. Let's now add another ingredient that the player will have to tap on to add it to the bowl. So you can do that by tapping again on this add a sprite button and then pick another ingredient that will be involved in your recipe. I'm gonna do a strawberry. Oh, and by the way, again here, you could draw a picture of the sprite or upload a picture or take one if your ingredient isn't available here. So I'm going to add a strawberry for my cake and I'm going to make it a little smaller. Let's see if I can manage this. I think that's good. Actually make the salt a little smaller too. So we wanna make it so that when the player taps on the strawberry, it gets added to the bowl. And one block that can help with that is this go to sprite block. So if you drag that out and choose a sprite from this little menu, that will make the strawberry go to whatever that sprite is. And we could have it do that when it's tapped. And there's this block, when tap. And if you And if you attach that on top, and you can tap the play button to have the strawberry go back to where you had dragged it to before. And so now you can see when you tap on the strawberry, it goes there. And we can also have it hide after it goes to the bowl, so it's like it really got added to the bowl. And for that, you could go to the scene category and drag out this hide block. And so let's try that out. So start it there and then tap on the strawberry and it disappears. You could also change the hide speed to be instant if you want. And I think I'll do that. So let's reset it again. Yeah, I like that. Oh, and you know what? Let's also make the strawberry play a sound when we add it to the recipe. So I'll drag out another play sound block. And if you want to add a different sound than the one that the sprite comes with, you could tap here and then tap this button to add a new sound. There's a sound I like that is called click. And I feel like that could be nice for adding the strawberry. So I'll add that and let's give that a shot. Nice. And I'm also gonna make this one play sound and continue so that it plays instantaneously. And now, last but not least, let's have it so that once the player has added all the ingredients, they can tap the bowl to have it turn into the final product. Also, as a side note, you could add as many other ingredients as you want, but I just figured I would show you these two. So let's add a sprite that will be the final dish. You can tap add a sprite again. And as with before, you could always add in your own images if you want. And I'm going to add the cake, and it comes in pretty small, so I'm going to make it bigger, put it like about there. That's where I want it to show up. The best way in OctoStudio to have a sprite turn into another sprite or change its appearance is to have the first sprite hide and then have the second sprite show up instead. So I'll show you how to do that. So this cake, we don't want it to be showing at the beginning of the game. So let's make it hide when the game starts, and I'll actually make it hide instantly when the game starts. So just to check, okay, that works. We've got the cake hidden. And so let's go to the bowl and let's make it so that when the bowl is tapped, it will hide. And let's just try that out. So if I tap it, it makes it hide. So how can you make the cake appear when the bowl is tapped? One easy way to do it is to go to the control category and have the sprite send a message. Basically, with the message blocks, you can have one sprite send out a message, and then you can make another sprite do something specific when it receives that message. So if I go to the cake, I can say, when I receive message one, then have it show. So if I tap the bowl, it turns into the cake. We can also have a sound go with this. So maybe we'll have the cake play a sound when it appears. So I'll drag out another sound block and let's test it all out. We can shake to add the salt. If it would detect, okay, yeah, there we go. And we can add the strawberry and then you can tap the bowl to have it turn into the final product. So there you go. Now, one thing you may notice is that technically, if we tap the play button and just tap on the bowl right away, it just turns into the cake. The player doesn't actually have to add the ingredients first. So later I will make a part two to this video where I'll show you how to make it so that the person has to actually add the ingredients. But for now, I figure this was a pretty nice little cooking simulator to get started with. So yeah, I hope you had fun. Let me know how it goes. I'm always happy to answer any questions if you've got them. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.